the Lord said to Abram, which is Abraham. Underline, please. After Lot had separated from him. Underline that. After Lot had separated from him, lift your eyes now and look from the place where you are, northwards, southwards, eastwards, and westwards. Verse 15. For all the land which you see, underline, which you see, I give to you and your descendants forever. Verse 16. And I will make your descendants as the dust of the earth, so that if a man could number the dust of the earth, then your descendants also could be numbered in the freedom. Then your descendants will also be numbered. My message is entitled Faith Pictures. Faith Pictures. The last time I spoke to you, I spoke on the authoritative utterance. The authoritative utterance. The authoritative utterance is the declaration or declaring the decree with boldness. Authoritative utterance, declaring the decree with boldness. It's a speech. It's our God-given ability to create as the Creator creates. A God-given ability. It is what God said about you. What is the decree? The decree is, this day I have begotten you, and whatever you ask, it will be given unto you. That's the decree. Authoritative utterance is declaring the decree, is speaking or enforcing what is God's law. When God created man, it was the last of his creation. It was the last of his creation. After that, everything that was created by man. The word is dominion. Dominion, it is not only saying authority or power or to dominate. It is saying a transformation or transferring decisions making to man. Dominion. It means the ability to make decisions that controls your circumstances. The ability to make decisions, watch this, that controls or dominate your circumstances. The greatest weapon in warfare is declaration. Declaration is authoritative utterance, which is declaring the decree with boldness. Amen. Declaring the decree. What is the decree? The decree is what God made as law. What is it? Well, this is it. That this day I have begotten you, and whatever you ask for, that's the decree, it shall be given you. But today, what I'm about to tell you, what I'm about to give you, is a next level of spiritual warfare. With a next level of spiritual warfare, you must have a next level of spiritual or weapons for spiritual warfare. I told you that declaration, authoritative utterance, is one of the greatest weapons in spiritual warfare. But there's a next weapon that I want you to be mindful of. Now, this is what the Lord has told me about 2 years ago, but I could not have revealed it unless you are prepared for this next level of the weapons of the next level of spiritual warfare. This weapon is as powerful as utterance, or in some cases, it might be even more powerful than authoritative utterance. This weapon is faith pictures. This weapon is the power of silence. You will find out that in some cases, the power of silence is even greater than utterance. When you can picturize or imagine. Imagination is simply an act of forming ideas. Write that down. That's imagination. You have to remember that. A act of forming ideas. Because you will never be able to speak it in the power that you should speak it unless you first think it. There's got to be a reason why Paul said that you must not be conformed to this world, but you must be transformed by the renewing of the mind. Because in the next level of spiritual warfare, the weapon is in the mind. You cannot even say it until you think it. So in order to say it, you have to think it with your mind's eyes. That is what we call picturalizing. It's to see it in your mind's eye. It's before you get it, before you touch it before you possess it. You have to see it. Now Habakkuk understood this. In Habakkuk chapter 2 and verse 1, he said, I will stand upon my watch. I will stand upon my watch. It simply means that I will not be moved. I will not be shaken. I will not let anybody take my focus. He said, I'll stand upon my watch and set me upon my tower, my high places, my strong places, authoritative, and will wait to see. He's understanding something. Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 1. He said, I will watch to see. He said, I will watch to see what he will say unto me. In other words, what he's saying here, I can't hear it unless I see it. And that's what I told you just now. You can't possess it unless you see it. You can't hear it or what you see. He said, I will watch to see what he will say unto me and what I shall answer when I am reproved. The word reproved there, watch it. It means corrected. And the Lord showed me that in order to go to your next dimension, you must be corrected. Because it's not everything you think is right going to be right. You're going to realize it's going to be right in 2015. God. To be corrected, it means that we have to be prepared for a shift. We have to be prepared to reposition our mindset. Say amen. Amen. If you're not prepared to reposition your mindset, you will always think the same way you used to think that kept you away from what God wanted you to have based on your mindset. And if you want something different, you have to do something different. If you want the breakthroughs that you did not get in 2014, you have to reposition. You have to stand ready to be corrected. In the scripture setting, you will understand quickly in the second portion, chapter 13 and verse 14, how that the Lord said unto Abram. The Lord said unto Abram. And then you will look at the next line. The next line that I told you to underline will remind you of the first portion of scripture. It is amazing how the Lord spoke to Abram. It's amazing. It's amazing how you can go through a period of your life, what we call the middle part of your life, the space between your beginning and your ending, is what you call your process. It's amazing how you can go through a process of nothingness. How you can go through a process that everything you try, you fail. And you wonder why. But in this case, we'll find out very quickly how that something happened and unhappened at the beginning and the ending of the process.
the beginning of the process, you will see this. You will see in verse 16 and chapter 12 how God spoke to Abram in that place. How God ministered to him. And verse 4 in chapter 12. So Abram departed. I believe that when God spoke to Abram at that time, he was ready for the blessing. He was ready for the blessing based on his prophetic word for his life. Yeah, I can read it right there. What he's saying in verse 1, he said, get out of your country. He's setting up Abram for something that he had never received before. He said, get out of that country, leave your family. That's big. He said, leave your father's house, his inheritance. He said, now, I'm asking you to leave all that because I have another plan for you that is bigger than everything you can ever give up for me. And he's hearing these prophetic words, and he's excited about it. The prophecy is based on Abraham. Is based on a seed. It had nothing to do with Lot. But if we look at verse 4, the Bible says, when Abram departed, as the Lord had spoken unto him, the Bible says, and Lot went with him. Now, and Lot went with him. Now, from that time to the next time in chapter 13, we will read now in the 14th verse, the Lord said unto Abram after Lot was separated from him. So there's a period, there's a process, there's an empty space from the time Lot started hanging with him to the time Lot was separated from him. I'm trying to tell somebody that there's people in your life, if you keep them, they will keep back your blessing from flowing the way God had prophesied it unto you. You have to understand that your blessing is not about people in your life. It's about your promise. It's about your destiny. And this year in 2015, you have to cut some people out of your life in order to get the fullness of the fulfillment of your prophecy. Somebody say hallelujah. And Lot went with him. You will find that you will go through things and you will want to know why nothing is happening the way it's supposed to happen. So much hindrance and so much setbacks, delays, disappointments. Check the people that is in your life that not supposed to be in your life. Your prophecy is not for people, it's for you. I'm trying to tell you this morning that in 2015, God wanna bless you all by yourself. It doesn't matter what they think, it doesn't matter what they do, it doesn't matter if they're with you, if they're not with you, if they support you, if they don't support you. God wanna bless you all by yourself. And from the time Lot was separated, now let me put it this way, from the time Lot hook up with him, nothing happened. Until the time Lot was separated from him. Isn't that something? There's a space there. There's a blank space in your life. Check the people who you're committed to. There's a blank, there's empty space. That everything you try, you fail. Check your friends. It's possible somebody's blight is leaking over on you. It's possible that somebody's curse is hanging along you. Get it out of your life. Get some Lots out.